I can do that.
You're welcome.
No, I just have everybody's. Okay, welcome everyone to this wonderful training that is going to be given by the president of RNetwork, Richard Smith. If everyone could just scoot in to help, we do not have extra chairs to put in. So just scoot in and everything. Jeremy is recording this. It's www.teamkaizen.us for those that, if you have friends that need to see this. So welcome again. It's exciting. And Richard, where are you?
I'm behind you.
Okay. There you go.
They call these Super Saturdays. I call them UCK. But thank you for coming. Why do I say UCK? Because it's sunny outside and I want to get outside and so do you. So we're not going to be a Saturday. We're going to be an hour and a half, depending on your questions. This Super Saturday is all about training you about the compensation plan. We're doing a lot of revolutionary things here at the RNetwork that's going to change everything. The rev card and the rev account are one thing. One of the things that I'm most proud of is the compensation plan of the RNetwork. It's been in development for years, creating a system that doesn't have the tangible gotchas of other compensation plans. So in most multi-levels, there's one of three systems. There's a fourth one that's kind of iffy, but I don't really consider that multi-level, and that's the Australian two-up. And I'm not even going to explain that one because it's too hard to explain. But the old stair-step breakaways, which you're looking at Amway, you're looking at Mary Kay, they're the ones that you have to run faster than your downline in order to stay ahead of them, or you lose your organization. What does that do? It solidifies the guys at the top of the organization because the cream always rises to the top, but it's not fair for the ones that can't run fast enough. It's a smoke and mirror. Then unilevels came along, and unilevels is all about me. I go as wide as I possibly can, and the ones that succeed, great. The ones that die, who cares? And there's no help for anybody. It's a dog-eat-dog world, and everybody's competition with everybody. Then you have the binary systems. What is a binary system? It's two legs. And so everybody runs around and recruits. All you got to do is get two people. That is a lie. Every time in a binary system, there's a runaway leg called a power leg. And everybody's chasing their power leg because you only get paid on your weak leg. So the volume that happens in the power leg is just phantom. It makes you feel like you're successful, but you're always constant, and everybody has a weak leg. So there's multiple weak legs, and generally there's only one or two real power legs in the entire company, and the company captures those monies. Is everybody with me so far? The last one I'm going to mention is the matrix. They don't work because, quite frankly, it's an all-for-one, one-for-all mentality, and that's communism. Or at least socialism. So if you're deep enough down in the organization, let's say you're down on the 243 line and you were the first person enrolled in a traditional matrix, everybody you enroll goes sideline to you. Until that row is filled up, nobody gets credited to you until that row is filled up. It is absolutely doesn't work. I'll just flat out say it. Now, you're going to hear people tell you, well, that's a matrix. It's not going to work. No, it's not. It's a team building system. Every single person that you enroll falls in the first open spot under you, not the company. You see the difference? It enrolls people to success. So for the first time in network marketing history, everybody helps everybody. The upline can help you, and they will. And I'll tell you why they will. There's only three spots for them to fill in the TBS. But in order to unlock all their 10 tiers, they've got to personally enroll 10. Does everybody see that? Well, where's the fourth person go? It's got to fill in somewhere underneath your first three. Do they move around after that? No. So I've got a lot of people that are really new into this that are scrambling, saying, my people aren't falling in the TBS side underneath me. What's going on? Why are they 5, 6, 7 levels down? You got to love that. Because what that does is there's now 5 or 6 people that are going to help that person. I will tell you right now, if I had my druthers on the whole organization, I'd want to be under Jeremy Jenkins about 3 of his legs, because I know my efforts are going to be drastically smaller than their efforts. I've got people in here that's going to have the whole Japan underneath them, and they had no clue about that. Do you see the power of this? How does a rope work? Many strands make one strand. Is that powerful? Yep. Is that more powerful than they did it? Yeah, they've tried all kinds of things, and even cables do the same process of ropes. Let me tell you another thing about this compensation plan. We pull people to success rather than pushing them to success. Who traveled the farthest? Probably you. Montana? Maybe. Anybody further than Montana? Where are you from?
Well, I'm from here, but I've traveled to Germany.
Oh, I can't have you. You're going to fly, and that my analogy doesn't work. But we'll go with Montana. If I gave you a chunk of rope 6 feet long, or six or 8 feet long, told you you had to push that back to Montana, would you ever get home?
No.
It'd be all over the place for you, wouldn't it? If we tied it on the back of your truck or your car or whatever you're driving home, would it slow you down much at all? This compensation pulls people to success. Now, there's going to be a lot of questions you guys are going to have today, but the main reason you're here is because I want to instruct and have the people on the live stream and you understand the power of the compensation of our network. All right? Now, before we get started, why did we shut down? Everybody asking that? You overwhelmed us. And I am an entrepreneur by heart, and sometimes damn the torpedoes isn't the best answer. And we launched, and I think we've got about 5,200 people that came in. Well, our SSL certificate wasn't completely complete. I'm going to let Jeremy jump up here with me and tell you a little bit about what that means.
Okay. So SSL certificates is the typical thing in the whole internet, right? You have to have, if you ever see HTTPS on your web browser, that is a secure connection, right? So you have to have that if you're dealing with credit card transactions or anything with, you know, to do with secure stuff, private information, your social security number, and all those things. And to verify that it's a secure connection, you have to have a certificate issued by, you know, somebody that's helping you. In this case, we're dealing with Microsoft, with we're using their Azure servers. And so Microsoft, unfortunately, is delaying that for whatever reason. They're testing it. And but until we get that certificate, we got all kinds of problems, like the emails are going to your spam, right? Because it can't verify that it's a legitimate company or legitimate website that it's coming from. We're having the issues with the credit card stuff. So there's all these things. They thought, well, you know what? We can just do a workaround. People are anxious. Let's get going and everything, and just kind of warn people, hey, it's going to go to spam and all that. Well, it ended up causing problems because of the exponential growth, right? You always have that issue. You put in 5,200 people in 24 hours, and everyone's freaking out. Oh, what's going on? And it causes confusion. So because of that, that's the main reason we shut down. So they're going to fix that once that's fixed with the certificate. And then once we've made some fixes on all the problems that it caused, right, then we can go ahead and launch back up, and things should be hopefully pretty smooth from then on.
Time schedule?
Go ahead.
Next week. Next week.
Friday?
No. We're going to work faster than that. Better not jump out that quick. We're planning on being quicker than that. I was asked before, there's a couple of things that people have asked me as I walked into the room. How well funded are you? Well, there's a couple of things. Number one, this whole project, we're not building anything brand new. The card seems very, very new, but the card has all the technologies that's already been developed for years and already proven and tested, and that we're just compiling it all into one card. So take ease of that. Also, NetChain 2 has been around and functioned forever. Trent and his technical team are absolutely on it. And no matter what you think about the card is just the hardware that makes this work. I'm sure we're all familiar enough now that we understand the magic in computers isn't the box, or the magic in the phone isn't the box or the phone itself. Where's the magic come from? It's a software. Trent's team built a pay solution for Google. They got bought by the manufacturer of the cards because of that NetChain software. Does everybody understand that? Also, our database, I've used every major multi-level software I can think of. There might be some new ones, but I've used all the big ones. And all the major multi-levels have used that. Now, these software companies go and shotgun. They try to take care of the stair-step breakaways. They try to take care of the binaries. They try to force new companies into something they've already done. Well, what I'm about to show you, they don't know what to do with. I've tried four different multi-level companies to force them to do what we're doing. And we have a PhD programmer. What does that mean? He teaches programmers how to program, and he came in as a partner with us. And he is going and has built in 10 days something that's unbelievable. In fact, Jeremy's like, that TBS drill down is something spectacular. And you all see how spectacular it is when we get it all harnessed and all together. Why did we launch? Because I know how fast we're moving from the other end, and I need you guys to actually start building your teams of charter members. Why? Because the charter members are going to be the ones that put in all the members, and we're going to create a dynasty here. So your first movers, you're welcome, and I'm sorry. Okay? But you're going to be justly rewarded for your being in very first. Is there any questions about why we shut down anymore? When we go back up, we're going to work flawlessly, aren't we, Kevin? By the way, this is one of my co-creators, Kevin Wiscombe. And Kevin is going to be working with the failed. We're going to have three master members and three chief trainers. We'll announce them here in a week or so, who they are. I love every one of them, and I have them in their positions, and we haven't called all of them. I say called because we're actually asking them to accept a position. They're kind of the straddle between you guys and us guys, because that is all our network. And we're going to create a very simple, streamlined, duplicatable system so that you can build your organization strong and effectively. Do you have a question? Okay. Yes.
So when does this soft launch start? Pre-launch start. When do we have to have our 10?
Okay, great question. I'll answer the 10 later, but I'll say we're going to go from the soft launch to the pre-launch June 6th. Payday's right after that. So everything you've done in the soft launch, we're going to start paying right then. Okay? There are people in this room, like two of them I absolutely know, are going to make tens, maybe even hundreds of thousands of dollars a month before we even send out our first card. It's pretty impressive.
Awesome.
Why is that? Why can I make that statement? John Johnson, why can I make that statement?
Yeah.
Who agrees this is a fairly easy story to tell? everybody gets it. Is there anything really hard to explain? Pull out this card, you swipe it, you get discounts, and 10 people get paid. It's not too tough. Now, I started saying we pay up to 1% up to TBS, right? If you've noticed, the last 5 or 6 times I haven't said anything at all. And I'll tell you why. There's times we're going to get more. When you put your rev card into the gas pump, there's a pretty good chance we'll get more than that. Sometimes we'll get less. We're going to, everything we get back from the merchant processors is going into TBS on a monthly pay. So before I start showing you how the magic of this compensation and how everybody helps everybody, there's 2 different types of pay. There's a weekly pay that's paid out in the pen, your personal and enrollment network. Those are the people that you bring and that they bring and that they bring. It has nothing to do with the TBS. It's your personal enrollments. Those checks on that side pay out weekly. In other words, from Friday to Friday, whatever gets billed gets paid out the following Friday, consistently, week in and week out. What falls in that? The subscription for the charter membership. So every time somebody gets a $38 charge, that following Friday, we are going to pay out the $2 respectively, how it pays out. Anytime somebody sells a card. Some of you are never going to sell a card because you're not going to need to. What do I mean by that? Because your grandfather's static, because you got in first, you're not going to have to get customers. Your charter members is going to qualify you for your customer base. When we launch January 1, what you are now is a charter member. What? Oh, 6. See, that's why I have him here. We didn't want to do it on while you're celebrating New Year's Day. So we did it the 6th.
First Monday.
It's the first Monday of the new year. So when we launch, nobody's going to be able to be a charter member until they have 10 cards placed. It's by invitation only. So being a pioneer has its advantages. Does everybody understand that? So on January 6th, from then on, everybody that builds is going to have to go get 10 cards placed before we invite them to make the jump over to charter membership. Any questions about that? Okay. Linda has one. What's that?
Why wouldn't it be sooner to help?
To help what?
To help the...
Create more customer base.
To create more of a customer base versus...
A couple of reasons. Number one, she wants to know why don't we don't launch the requirement to get 10 customers before we launch. Because I want to make darn sure with people that are actually my business partners that everything's running exactly precisely as we want. Because the hardest skeptics in this is going to be your customer base. And I also want the opportunity to get clear out there because there's a couple of people in here, in fact, pretty much all of you, it's going to have a worldwide organization. And I want the discounts worldwide. And that gives me the opportunity to bring that piece in before we make the mandatory customer base. Make sense, Linda?
Makes sense.
Thank you. Great question. All right. I have dreamt about doing this my entire life. I think I was somewhere between 8 and 9 years old. And my dad was a member of A.O. Williams. Is there some of the older people in here that know what I'm talking about? I used to steal Art Williams' dad gummit tapes, and it was a cassette tape, out of the mailbox, and I'd plop it in and listen to it before dad got home from selling paint. And I wanted to buy term and set, invest a difference, and I was sold on that. Once I started moving into the relationships of understanding multi-level, I was trained by Robert Lovell, Chris Apostle, Errol Aberson. These are some of the pioneers in this industry. Every one of them made millions of dollars building organizations with Sunrider, NSA. I could go on and on and on. Can I tell you just what Errol Aberson said about this comp plan? And let me tell you how the story happened. So he's one of my mentors. What a mentor is to me is somebody you don't sell to and he doesn't sell to you, but you just shut up and listen to him. I gave him a call. He lives in Vancouver, British Columbia. And I said, Errol, can I send you something? He goes, yeah, what you doing? And he called me Rick. He goes, what you doing, Rick? And I told him, I sent it to him. He looked over it and called me up and he said, can we talk? I said, sure. Are you going to come to me or am I going to come to you? He said, Tuesday afternoon, I think it was Tuesday afternoon. This was quite a little while ago. He said, Tuesday afternoon, go to the Provo Airport and I'll meet you. I'm like, the Provo Airport? So I'm sitting there parked. I thought, man, what's going on here? A brand new, shiny, I don't know what it was, Gulfstream, I think, lands, taxis in to the Provo Airport. He comes down off the gateway, motions me to come over. I go up into this nice, nice airplane. I'm like, man, is it going to take me somewhere? We sat there for about an hour and a half, and I was expecting to tear apart this comp plan. And he didn't. He just asked questions. By the time we were done, and it was about an hour and a half, he turns to me and goes, whatever you tie this to, as long as it's not something stupid and hokey, could change the world. Good luck. Stepped out of the airplane, and I thought it was his. In fact, I used to tell the story that it was his. Come to find out it was the MGM Grand's. He's a big gambler, and they went and got him. And he,
of
and he made him fly to Provo first before they took him to Vegas. I share that with you because this wasn't just by happenstance. What Troy and I have created in this compensation plan is the real power of the RNetwork. Now, don't think that I'm not absolutely bouncing off the walls with the product and service that we're bringing to you. Where else can you sell something that's not a sell? It's an invite to save money. And when they save money, you get paid. This compensation deserves this product, and this product deserves this compensation plan. I'm tired of defending it. I'm tired of people having their own stinking thinking from their own experience in multi-level. It does not matter where you fall in the TBS. Let me repeat myself. It does not matter where you fall in the TBS and where your people fall. Every single tier pays out the exact same. Nobody gets paid any difference no matter where they fall. The whole purpose is we're braiding that rope upline, downline, and sideline helps you. People are going to sponsor other people that are going to fall under you, and that is sideline help traditionally in a multi-level, and you're going to get credit for their swipes for the rest of your life. And then you're going to will it to your children, and they're still going to get paid from it. Does that make sense? Have I made myself perfectly clear? Maybe not.
I'm new to this, so I don't quite understand everything. But how is it that in a tiered system, everyone gets paid the exact same? I mean, is it just paid? I mean, so there's
It's not exact same. It's the exact same per tier, and I'll get to that while I explain it to you. Great question. Clarification, I said every tier pays out the exact same. Not everybody gets paid out the exact same.
Okay, all right.
Every tier in your entire organization gets paid. And why did I call it tiers instead of levels? I'll bet there's only a handful of people that know that. I'm going to pick on the one that I know knows it, so I don't embarrass anybody. Jeremy, why do we call it tiers instead of levels?
Because of the compression.
Exactly. Dynamic compression. A level is, this is what's on that level, and you get paid on that level. It's not levels, it's tiers. And I'll get to that while I explain the compensation, but everybody gets tiers. And the tier is the question asked. The computer asks three questions. Number one, are you active? Number two, is that person on the tier that you're getting paid from active? And number three, are they tier qualified? That's all you have to remember. Those three things. Am I active? Have I got my tier activity on there? And that's all you have to ask yourselves. Does everybody understand that? Maybe. I'm jumping ahead of myself, but then I'll go back and explain myself. All right. I hope I made myself abundantly clear. It doesn't matter where people fall. Bless John Johnson. He is recruiting some of the biggest dynamos, and he's making this fight every minute he can because they don't understand. I'm going to give you power and authority so you do understand. It really doesn't matter if your dynamo is on your third tier, because that dynamo is now going to get help, and they're going to help other people, those other two levels. They think it matters, but it really doesn't, does it, Jeremy? Okay. All right, let me explain how this thing's going to look when we get to the pre-launch stage. You guys got a little glimpse of what the TBS drill down is kind of going to look like. We're going to pretty it up. And when we go, well, before I go here, let me go here. Sorry about that. Everybody wants to know when we're going to win. Right now, we're in the soft launch phase. We're going to perfect the database and tie that in to NetChain, preparatory to going and introducing the bank. Every honking person I run into one-on-one, what's the name of the bank? I'm not going to tell you. I just signed the agreement of a well-brand name, and you're all be in here except for a couple of you are old enough to know this brand. I'm not going to tell you what that brand is, but you'll be proud of it. And we are going to have some fun with it, aren't we, Kevin?
Yes, we are.
Holy hell, we're going to have some fun with it. Okay? I also signed the agreement that the Hyper Dex, the exchange for cryptocurrency, by the way, did anybody see how much crypto's running today? Where's it at?
Almost seven grand
BTC. Pretty good run. You need to ask yourself, why is that happening? And I don't think it has anything to do with us, but you need to ask your question why that's happening. We are creating Hyperdex. The Larimers, Stan and Dan, are the foremost expert in blockchain technology. How can I say that? Because three of the top five coins exchanged on a daily moment-by-moment basis are their coins. In fact, EOS, BitShares, and Steam for transaction on a blockchain, of all blockchains, their three coins, there's over 80% of the volume of all the chains, of all the 21. They're building us our Hyperdex. We're going to deep state that inside your card. You'll access your wallet inside the card. And your Hyperdex is going to be located on cruise ships originally, and then eventually in space. We've already got our first server in space. Why space?
No jurisdiction.
Pretty secure, too. Pretty hard to hack into it physically. Pretty sure there's no country or nobody's going to build a satellite or a rocket ship to go up and hack into it. And way they crossed everything, I don't think they could even if they tried. Why is that important to you? Number one, every one of your cryptocurrencies will be insured 100%. Number two, instead of paying the fees that you pay and get gouged with the Coinbases of the world, per coin transferred, we're going to have a flat rate per transfer. A flat rate. So coin to coin inside the Hyperdex is going to be a dollar per trade. Did you hear me? Dollar per trade. when you move it from the vault or from the hyperdecks in, why did I say vault? It's been a long day. That's only morning. When you move it from hyperdecks into your wallet or in your fiat currency, it too will be flat. It'll be 595. Doesn't matter if it's $1 million. Does everybody understand that? Now, because everybody asked me what about call, I'm going to be very brief and I'm going to tell you this. When call gets onto exchange, it's going to have a place in hyperdex. That place is going to be a place of prominence when he gets it on an exchange. It will be the only coin that this card, the rev card, will immediately turn to cash on the fly. So if you're staying here in the Holiday Inn and you have no cash on your rev card, but you got a lot of calla, present your calla. It'll immediately go to cash and Holiday Inn Express will never know anything about it. Oh, and by the way, it still pays out the commissions up the tree. Yes.
There's not that $5.95 charge for that, is there?
For that?
It's turning calla to cash.
No. No. I'm trying to make calla be a priceless, priceless coin. That's all I'm going to say about that. Okay. Comp plan.
One yes. Question. So, somebody asked when. So, when might calla go to the exchange?
Yeah, you're asking the wrong guy. There's a bald guy that's a whole lot bigger than me. You want to go talk to him. So let's talk about timeline real quick before I get into this. So we're going to do pre-launch June 6th. At that point, we're going to invite you to download the app portion of what's going to be attached to the card, which is the discounts. It's not as sexy, but it'll get you the discounts. Should save you $50 to $80 a month. We're doing that before we bill you again because we want to be compliant and we want you to actually have a physical, tangible thing that's worthwhile to build your organizations around. Does everybody understand that piece? We will then start paying commissions. Those commissions are paid on the subscriptions and the descriptions only. So the weekly pay is based on subscriptions for the charter membership and any cards that ever get sold. We pay out on cards but by charter members, which will be $99. $10 goes up to TBS. When we sell a card to the retail customer, it is $150. We pay $25 to the guy that sold it or the girl that sold it to the enroller. And $10 goes up to TBS. Does everybody understand that? And that gets paid out weekly. Sometime shortly thereafter, once all the organization and all the things I'm signing left and right and the bank takeover happens and Trent gets in and does what he does, because a lot of these banks, there's three industries that are really slow on technology. Would you like to know what they are? No banks. Actually, the government, because the military is a little bit faster than these three. Banks are toast slow. When you go into the hospital, you get a DOS page. Whoop, comes up. And the airlines. You ever notice you go get try to get something done at Delta Airlines and they're... You're like, why don't you just take a mouse and go like this? Those three industries are really slow. And Trent's net chain is going to create the banks that we're taking over to be state of the art. Does that make sense? At that point, we're going to start doing the KYC and load you into your bank account. Everybody will establish a bank account. The KYC is part of the law. One person, one social security number, bank account. KYC, you're going to have to take a selfie. Ladies and gentlemen, don't get too bugged about that. Photo ID, selfie. That's going to prove that you are a natural person and that you are who you say you are. There's a lot of components to that that'll absolutely be cool. At that point, we're going to cut out the photo ID because nobody needs to know that. Deep state that into an encrypted field, and boom, it's there inside the vaults of the bank or the computer system of the bank. Your mug, however, is going to go into the pan because Jeremy Johnson wants to know who he's working with. Okay, everybody's going to have a photo that'll work in the pan. This demonstration of how tracking your system will be able, who has a phone? Can I get your cell phone? You're going to be able to build your business 100% on this if you want. Now, I'm immediately going to get somebody to ask me, can you do it on a PC? Of course you can. Thanks. But I want this generation and younger. I was actually talking to that one, but they're not even comfortable with PCs. Do you even own one?
No, they're not.
See? I want him to be able to go do what he does and have fun with it. So everybody you personally enroll, their face is going to be in that little circle and their name underneath it. And when you hold it down, guess what? It's going to pop up their content information, and you're going to be able to click on it and send them a text or an email. Now, what if you just go, don't hold it down, just click it. That person is now going to be in the middle, and you're going to see their entire organization. Can you keep drilling down all the way on it, doing it that way? What if you enroll more than 10? What if you put more than 10 in the pen? There's only 10 circles here. Now we're going to get real. Does everybody remember the old phones?
Yeah.
He doesn't. He's like, I saw it once in the. And then if you messed up, what did you have to do? You had to hung up, huh? You'll be able to take this, hold down on it, and spin it around, and this person will go underneath. You won't see him, and the new person will pop up. All the way through Jeremy Jenkins, 200 enrollments. Now you guys are all going to scratch your head and go, why is he doing 200? He's doing 200 because he cares about people. He's doing 200 because he wants to ensure he's always got 10 active in the pen. Now, the only time you need to worry about anything in your organization is your own personal enrollments. You want to know how to get wealthy in this? Lose your life in the betterment of others and help other people be successful. And Jeremy's not going to roll 200 all of them at once. John might. Getting close. Why do they keep enrolling? Because they know how to market, and anybody new, they come bring them in, and they make them a part of their team. But what he really does, and both of these guys do, how many phone calls you had with the doctor?
40 calls already.
He works with his people and he cares about them. And if you want to get me emotional, lose your life in the betterment of others and watch what happens to you. It's fun to make money. It's a whole hell of a lot funner to help other people make money and make money for them making money. And you don't have, trust me. Trust me on this one. So, when you sponsor your first three, one, two, and three, over in the TBS, if your upline hasn't already put people under you because they have to go somewhere, one would fall here, two would fall here, and three would fall there. It goes left to right, top to bottom, and then right to left, left to right, yep. Let me explain that. So I'm going to go 4, 5, and 6. 4, 5, and 6. Started out this way. You went and did all 6 of them all at once. Boom, 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 boom. And a lot of you have done that in here. 6 would fall. Oops. 4 would fall here. 5 would fall here. And 6 would fall here. Team by team, tier by tier. It always falls in the first open spot of your organization. Why did we do it that way? We wanted to space it out so that the people who are on the right side or on the left side don't get more of your help while you're first starting this. Does everybody understand that? So if I go get a 7, 8, and 9, tell me where they fall. Okay, so it starts back this way, doesn't it? 7, where would 8 fall?
Right there.
Right there.
Where would 9 fall?
Right there.
Now, if you keep going, you go 10, 11, and 12. 10, 11, and 12. Tell me what 1 and 2 think of you.
They love you.
Unless they're leaders, and then they're going to call you up and scream at you and say, you put people in my people. I want my people there. It does not matter. Have I got my point across on this one? It doesn't matter.
That's what you want to have.
But you'd be surprised, because there's been some sneaky thinking in the past. So, how many tiers are you qualified to for, Jeremy?
At that point?
Yep.
10.
10. You personally enrolled 11 or 12 people. You are absolutely tier 10 qualified. What happens when 9 starts to go get their 2, 3, and 4 people? First open spot under 9, right? What if 3's already got people before 9 has? They're going to fall in under here, right? Everybody helps everybody. We're braiding the blooming rope. These people technically in any other multi-level are sidelined to you. When has that ever happened before in multi-level history? Never. Your upline gave it to them. Your sideline is always going to build for you. Should you rely on that? No. Does it matter if you rely on it? You know what? If you want to sit on your haunches and watch this build out and sit there going this way, great. You know why? Because on the TBS side, we're going to show you your tiers and how much you would be making if you'd unlock the tiers. Somebody's going to call up madder than a wet hornet to John Johnson saying, there's $6,000 here. I missed $6,000. John, you screwed me. No, he was going to be able to calmly say, go get to work. Let me help you unlock that tier. See the magic in this? We're pulling people to success. If you were missing $6,000 and you needed to sponsor 2 more people, would you sponsor them?
No. So side helps side. If number 2 up there put somebody in, can he ever go under the people 7, 12, and 6?
No. Nope. It's always got to go in the first open spot under you. It wouldn't be fair if we did it any other way. When you do your energy, you should get your efforts. But other than that, everybody helps everybody else. Does that make sense? Do you realize the power of what you just heard? Get proficient at it. Now, we're going to create a real fancy, fun, loving video that's going to teach this. But you want to really look like a rock star? When somebody enrolls and they're excited as heck about the rev card, sit down on a one-on-one, either on a Zoom or a video chat. It's exactly what you do, don't you? And explain to that person the power of this compensation and what it really means to be a member or a charter member of the RNetwork. Yes.
So these placements are automatic by the computer. I don't have a choice.
You do not have a choice. If you want somebody to go into a very specific place, guess what? You give away the enrollment ship and they're not in your pen and they don't unlock a tier. Does that make sense? I did it that way because there's all these games that everybody plays and says, hey, if you get 3 people, I'm going to put 3 people underneath you. Just go build your honking pen and unlock your tiers. The secret of this is 10 in the pen that are active. Now, I know what's going to happen because these 10 people, how are you going to know when they're not active? When we go try to pull money out of their account to pay for the $38, and they don't have it in there, there'll be a red circle around it. Ooh, I bet I shouldn't have done it red. Now, if you have more than them, you probably ought to just leave them alone. If you don't, pick up the phone and say, what's going on? You might want to even help them. $38 for $6,000 is a pretty good change, isn't it? Linda.
Can you prepay for the year?
No, nope, you cannot. Yes,
maybe $35 at the end of the year.
That's what Linda just asked me, and I said, no, you cannot.
Can we change that?
No, we cannot. I need to point out something here because this is very important for me to explain to you. John and Jeremy, because I know what they're doing, and I'm picking on them too because they're there too. Everybody in here is included in this. I know Jeremy because he's going to have more than 10 people. If two ever becomes inactive, are you going to call him?
Yeah, I'll call him.
He will, but only because he loves them. Why wouldn't you call them?
I don't need them because it actually does me a favor by pushing it down deeper.
Did you hear what he just said? If that person is not active, he just went to his 11th tier in that leg and gets paid on all those people instead of one. So for the first time in multi-level history, your deadbeats give you a raise and go give him a kiss on the cheek. Let me repeat myself. Your deadbeats give you a massive raise in this compensation plan. And I'm going to explain how that works. Does everybody understand how it feels? Yes.
Okay. So I heard two different ideas there. One, you help them because you love them. And two is screw them because I'll get paid better at the end of the day. So, I mean, it can hurt you too, because if that 11th leg isn't doing anything, then you, and the 10th leg is, but you've got that hole because number two's not doing his thing, then you do take a hit there. But I'm just hearing two different messages there. We either love them or we don't.
And I love you to bring that up. And let me tell you why. I want that tug of decision making, because that's going to make you a better person. That tug of what do I do? I know what Jeremy Wearley would do. He'd float that person $38. But that's on you. All I'm trying to say is there's no gotchas in this system. The gotcha's inside of you. What kind of person are you going to be? Are you going to care about people or are you going to be greedy? Now, there's going to be people doing wild butt stuff, and we'll catch them. There are going to be people saying, man, I'm going to build out all me down to the 9 line. Woo! We'll catch them. One person, natural person, with a social security number, their equivalent in the country. You can't get an account without that, and you can't get a bank account without that. Yes.
Okay, so somebody already brought up the question, can we pay for the whole year, and you said no.
No.
But if can you pay, but I'm guessing you could pay for it month to month.
Yes.
Okay, so the question is, if number two is just dead set on not doing it, can you replace number two?
No, you can ask them to sell it. You can sell it to somebody else for them. It's their spot. But you can't replace them willy-nilly. They earned the right by being in this.
And how do they sell it?
There's a one piece of paper that there's a buy-sell agreement. We don't get involved other than we approve the person because we want to make sure they're not already in the system, the people to buy it. But it's simple. It's your spot. It's willable. You're to my, in fact, we've already had it. A dear friend named George passed away. And I went to the funeral on Thursday. His wife now is the proud owner of that spot. And because she already had a spot, she had to give one to her, one of her kids. She had 11 of them, so it's pretty.
Your favorite.
So, yes.
Can you, I put in my own name and my own social now, but if I'm able to put it into a business name later, can I switch it into a business name?
Absolutely. And for taxation purposes, you can absolutely have it in a EIN number. In fact, we're going to create some systems for you to work with accountants and lawyers, because the best place to have it really is either Nevada or Wyoming, and we're going to bring those services because we're going to treat this like a real life business because that's what your spot is. Yes.
You really can pay in advance for a year, right? Because you can, as long as you have your money in the bank.
Yeah, I'm being a smart aleck when I say no. The only place we're going to do it, we're not going to ding your credit card. You've established account, and you're going to give us authorization to do a direct withdrawal out of your account. You have enough money in there to pay for a year. You've effectively done what you asked me to do. Yes.
So what about other countries? How if they don't have Social Security?
There, everybody has a. Everybody has some type of number that their government tracks taxation with. Okay, now I got to talk about the dynamic compression of this. So we're going to pretend like we're not people of integrity. At least I'm not. You are. Fair enough? I need to explain, and it's not necessarily integrity. It's the way this system works. Does everybody understand? You all have a three line, and that's tier one. Does everybody understand that? What do I mean by three? There's three spots that can be filled. It's a lattice. It's a skeleton structure. It's a honeycomb. It's a beehive. It goes 3, 9, 27, 81, 243, and so on, down to 59,000. What's the?
88,572 total.
That's total. I'm not quite that good at the computer. So, everybody understands the bills like this. Every father and mother has multiple children, if they have multiple children, and their posterity grows exponentially this way. But if you go back up the tree, there's only one mother. Biological mother, there's only one. Am I right? In genealogy, that's the truth, right? I'm trying to get, come on, give me some. Same thing with this. When you look up the tree, every organization just has a straight line going back up the tree. Does everybody understand what I just said? Any no's? Because I'll explain it more for, okay.
Not sure.
Huh? Not sure?
Not sure.
Okay. When this person pays their dues, this person gets paid and this person pays. It's a straight line. When this one happens, same thing. It's a straight line. You can go all the way down to infinity. It's always a straight line coming back up through. Thank you for being humble enough to do that. So I'm going to draw the view going this way instead of the view going this way. So it's a straight line. All right, this person down here decides he's going to whip out his, he's doing really well in the organization, and he whips out his debit card and he goes and buys a $10,000 car. What's 1% of 10,000 bucks? Huh? 100 bucks. Okay, so there's $100, and I'll make him right here. $100 worth of commissionable volume on that one transfer of money to car. Everybody get we? The computer automatically does this. There's 10 people we need to pay out, so we divide it by 10 equals 10 bucks. Does everybody see that? Why did I use that? Because it's simple and everybody understands it. There's not going to be a lot of cars bought with the rev car, but there might be. We might be bringing something really, really cool that might happen that way. So they buy the car. Runs up the tree. Here's how the computer system is programmed. It asks three fundamental questions. Are they active? What tier? And what month does it, is it a monthly pay or a weekly pay? This is a swipe, so it'll be a monthly pay. Everything that has to do with building, charter members, or selling cards, it's weekly. Swipes are put in a commission account inside the bank to pay out commissions. Can Richard go write a check out of that commission account? Can I? No. Huh? I never can. That commission account's going to stay there forevermore. And it's going to have a blockchain reporting back to the bank. Why do I say that? This industry is rife, is it not? With CEOs and presidents and CFOs saying, John Johnson's making way too much dang money. He's making double what I'm making on a monthly basis. Let's mess with him. Who's heard of that before? This won't happen here. The only thing you're going to get terminated for is income claims and lying to people, and that'll be the peers of your own RNetwork. Am I understood? So the computer system asks those questions. Number one, is this person active, yes or no? Well, yes, they are. Number two, have they personally enrolled one person, yes or no? Well, yes, they have. Pay that person on this particular transfer, $10. Automatically goes to their account. The computer then asks the same question, but a little bit differently. Is this person active? Yes, they are. Have they personally enrolled two or more active people? The answer is yes. Pay them $10. Same question, a little bit different. Lindy, I have a question.
What considers, for those that don't know what active means?
$38. Everybody. They don't have a red circle around them.
Okay.
Does everybody understand that? $38, they don't have a red circle around them. The next question is, are they active and have they personally enrolled three? They haven't quite yet. They said, this is not for me. It was too hard to get the two. Skips over them. The computer doesn't ask the next question, which is if they enrolled four or not. It keeps asking the same blooming question till it finds somebody to pay. Have they sponsored three or more? No, they haven't. Have they sponsored three or more? Yep, bam. So these two got skipped. Then the next one, has they sponsored four or more? Yep, pay them. Five or more? Yep, pay them. Six or more? Nope. Six or more? Nope. Six or more? Nope. Six or more? Nope. Then it gets to Wayne Young. And he's definitely got six or more. He gets the $10. Folks, in order for you to get caught off on your organization, you have to have 10 people who have sponsored 10 people stacked on top of themselves. Hello? Am I right? 10 people who have sponsored 10 people. How deep is it going to go? Jeremy, when we were running things, how deep did some of your legs go?
200-something level.
He was getting paid on. So does it matter where they fall, John? It doesn't matter. In fact, you want, for heaven's sakes. If you had one leg that had 10 that they had 10, you're just bringing in the money. Right?
I thought you only get paid on your 10 and the 10.
Nope, you get paid on any tier. All the way down throughout everything. All you have to do is worry about 10 in the pen so you unlock the beast and get paid out whatever happens. Yes?
So I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around like that 243. So if one person there generates $100, like how does it decide which of those 81 above it goes to? Because it can't go.
It doesn't. It just goes to the direct person above them. So everything is a little microcosm of free. So one begets three, one that begets three, all the way down. So when somebody buys, the one that's directly above gets paid. So don't convey this with how it pays. Everybody that's underneath you in your organization, if you've unlocked 10, you're getting paid on all of them. I had to go down to myopic one level to explain how this happens. Does that make sense? You're going to go, Levi,
yes.
Will you sit down with this guy and show me your spreadsheet and do your magic and do your disclaimers? This has no, da, 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 da. Okay?
Can you make a copy for me?
Yeah. Why is this such a somehow I'm going to either draw this on. A lot of people put a lot of things on their tombstones. If you want to know what's on my tombstone, it's going to be two things. Nothing dies a more tragic death than success left unattended. I am going to fight like a mama bear with two cubs being attacked by some wild beast to make sure this opportunity stays for your kids' kids. Number two. Nothing dies a more tragic death than success left unattended. I will never leave this unattended. Number two, he who builds no castles in the air, build no castles anywhere. And this right here. The TBS, the team building structure, and the way it works is going to revolutionize multi-level forever. And it finally has to have a product that makes sense that the masses want. When you're trying in a 3x10 organizational tree, or everybody's trying to get 10 in the pen, and you're trying to stuff 10 people per person into a 3x10, you want to run some numbers, run that booming one, right, Jeremy?
Oh, yeah.
You're not even down to tier four, and your whole entire matrix, your 88,000 people, are filled up. Well, what does that mean with everybody else that's trying to get in under there? They're all just going to braid the rope and pull it to Montana. Does everybody feel pretty confident and settled in there, except for you, and you're going to meet with him? You don't have to worry about this whole thing. What you need to worry about, I unlock all my earning potential by having 10 active people in the pen. Personal enrollment network and team building structure is the organization. Wayne?
Will we be able to see all the 10 tiers, all 88,000 people on our screen?
You can now, and it's a way that you can do it on the phone. And you just drill down whichever leg you want to go in. And it's pretty unique and pretty satisfying, isn't it, Jeremy? In fact, that's the number one on this whole fiasco of moving too fast and doing it before the SSL. My number one feedback is, holy crap, the intuitive nature and the ease of use of drilling down through my TBS. You did this in 10 days? Yep, we did. And it's only going to get better. Yes.
Is that currently available? We do it today?
Well, no, because we pulled the plug on everybody. Yes, Levi.
International markets rollout and registration for international.
Perfect. Thank you so much. There is a love of my life, and that is that we get the whole world to participate in that. We are going to open up, when we open back up, the whole of South America, minus a couple of countries. Venezuela is going to be kind of tough. We're going to open up the whole South America. You know, we've already got Japan. Shortly thereafter, we're making sure we're compliant because on the 25th of this month, the UK, the whole UK has got fines. If you do something wrong per incident is a 20, is it 10 or 20?
20,000.
It's a 20,000. 20 euro,
yeah.
20,000 euro fine.
So
the whole EU. So that'll come online. We're very confident because BMAC codes everything in code. You can't even push a button that we don't do encryption on it. So that coupled with the fact that we're using Microsoft Azure servers and the newest ones, we feel quite confident we'll be able to do the whole entire EU. Right thereafter. Now, I've already got asked about Nigeria and some of the African nations. Guys, we launched a day ago. Slow the heck down. We're going to get there. Kevin.
Just take that one step further. For what Levi, I think, was asking me, he was whispering to me. The zip code, right? So the zip code's in the payment system. Not being able to accept even the US zip code, that has been fixed already. Let me read back over.
Australia, Brazil, Mexico, Canada.
They'll all be on that in the drop down. When we've opened back up. Okay, a couple of them that won't. China won't. Of course, any one of them that's on the, what list is it called? Do you remember the name?
I know what Trent called it, but I shouldn't repeat it here.
There are certain countries we will never be in. China's not one. We're gonna get there. Any country that has a debt, has an ATM capability, most likely will be there, except for one. Russia. The Russian mafia controls the cards. And until there's a revolution and get the mafia out of there, we're just not going to venture in there yet. So we don't want to hurt the growth of the rest of the world because we get one bad apple called Russia. Do I want to? Oh, yeah. I've had some beautiful calls with some Russians. And they are, the people themselves, are some of the best-hearted people I know. In fact, we had one where I had to speak in English. He had to translate to Spanish, and that Spanish speaker went to Russian. Want to talk about an interesting call. And my instant messages got filled with Russians begging us. Whatever we got to do to figure out how we can have the RNetwork here in Russia, we're going to do. We're going to try our best, but we're not going to jeopardize all the rest of us to move in there. Levi, did you have a question?
Yeah, countries like China and some Asian countries really don't use cards anymore. They just use apps to pay. Will this Rev app have the full functionality to be able to pay?
What if we make the card work like their app? What if I told you this card has the potential to replace your phone? What if I told you some of those things are coming down the pipe? You got to understand the chip in this honking thing. Is there a speaker on it, on the card? Is there a mic on the card?
Yes.
Is there one of the most aggressive miniature Intel chips on the face of the planet in the card? Yes. I talked about it to some of the people that are in the know, and their flat out answer back is, let's see who wins. So my message to you, don't rule the card out. And I'll tell you right now, the regulators in this country, say they're never going to go away from the card. The card's always here to stay. There's banks. Do you know the chip, instead of swipe, the chip is against the law if you don't have a chip. Did everybody know that? My credit union doesn't have chip readers yet. The bank doesn't have the chip reader yet. We're very slow adopters. The answer to your question, I don't know on some of them. I was worried about that in Japan, really worried. But they love the technology in the car. They'd much rather carry that than their phones because they get killed with fees on their phones. Any other questions? Yes.
Would the website open back up all the terms and conditions?
Absolutely. Instead of gibberish, big Latin, it's already fixed. You notice I keep looking at Kevin because he's on it more than I am. Any other questions? Yes.
When do we need to have our 10?
As soon as you want to get paid. Non-
talk about family members.
Oh, I'm going to. Okay. I'm going to wrap up with that.
Okay.
You need to have 10 in the pen as soon as it matters to you. When you have your first person 10 levels deep, Jeremy, I know, and so does John, they both have their 10. And I think one of the two of you, is it the 20th tier we have already filled?
I haven't seen the whole.
Yeah, I think there's one of you that are already starting to feel in one of your legs, tier 20. Dude, we've only been doing this a day. The answer is as soon as you can. But take your time.
Is there perks doing it by a certain date?
Okay. From now until launch, there are some perks. You guys are pioneers, and I want to call you founders. We're going to have
January 6th.
Everybody that has 10 in the pen by January 6th is going to be known as a founder member. I'm going to create a special little pin for you. You're going to get the, and I'll never say this again. In fact, I ought to have Kevin stand up. You'll get first participation in what John's doing over at Method. You also will receive an extra 50 cents per subscription of in your organization until we launch. Does that make sense? So there's three major things. Number one, you always have that perm. I was a founding member of the RNetwork. Number two, you're going to get participation in Method and get to own the bank. Number three, there's an extra 50 cents instead of getting paid $2, and I still got to go over that too. Instead of getting paid $2, you get paid an extra 50 cents, $2.50 per tier. And everybody that's a founding member gets first in line to get their cards. Okay? And you're going to be several weeks first. You want to get the call. You want to get 10 in the pen. Yes.
So how will we know next week when we can start?
Well, you'll know. We're going to blast it out to everybody. A couple things. Does everybody understand this? Can I erase it?
I have one more question.
Okay.
So you were saying on each tier, every tier gets paid the same, right?
Yep.
And then each person varies. So you were saying
each person
doesn't get paid the same for each tier.
The volume of every tier is the exact same thing. Has anybody heard me say anything about percentages? I always talk in simple math dollars. So you notice as it was going up the tree, every tier gets paid $10 on this particular example. It always pays out the same on all 10 tiers. So we don't pay out some on this tier, on this level, and some up more on that, different percentages. We just straight up pay out a dividing 10, and we run it up to TBS. Now, before I go into this next thing, the average major account using a debit card in the United States is $1,500.
Per month.
You use that to pay your light bill, your phone bill, you're eating out. Most people use their debit card for pretty much everything. There's one thing you can't use your debit card for, so you do an online bill pay to pay your mortgage. Part of the process of the KYC into the bank, we're going to ask you who your mortgage holder is. Not because we want to go buy it out yet. But when you use our bill pay and pay your mortgage, there's 1% paid out the tree that way too. Our goal is minimum to have $3 per person per active charter member pay out to the upline. $3. Well, on 88,000 people, $3, is anybody starving to death? How about 1,000 people? Is anybody starving to death? The other thing is January 6th, everybody that's going to be invited to be a charter member has to go get 10 cards placed. Where do those fall? They stack on the top. They stack on the top of the charter member at the charter member's volume.
That's huge.
The member gets paid 10 basis points for whoever they refer.
Are you not talking about charter? You're talking about customer.
Just a customer. So what we're going to do is you got to earn the right to be a charter member. So we're going to pay them for their first 10 before they're even a charter member. And all that volume stacks on top of you. We might be $10, $20 per tier per charter member. Do that by 88,000. Do you see the power of what we've produced here? You don't need a whole lot of big money when you have big numbers. You can get wealthy. The banks are getting wealthy on basis points. Visa, MasterCard, are staggeringly successful, and they only get like 2 basis points per swipe. Folks, you're giving people their bank and their wallet, and you're the banker.
But don't say that.
Yeah.
Okay, clarification for those that are having. Okay, if you have a well, meaning somebody that has a large organization.
Like somebody I know? Go ahead, Linda.
So, okay, so they're not on 1, 2, 3, they're at the top. So this well comes in with this large organization. Some people don't understand how that is going to help.
Okay, let's say this well, let's say this upline mm-hmm. brings in the well, mm-hmm. and before the well gets started, a few of these positions get pushed by the upline. Well, the well starts, guess what? It's got to fall in the first open spot. The whale is going to fill in all the rest of them, but are these two going to get these 9 or 20 going to get a free ride? Nope, they still got to do the same thing as the whale's doing and go put 10 in the pen. But yeah, there's a chance, don't rely on it, but there's a chance that you might get a whale in just one of your legs. Do you care? You're getting paid on it. Just unlock the tiers, for Pete's sakes. Does that make sense? Levi.
Or people that are looking at bringing in new people, now that we've already started, if you know that they know somebody that is a whale, so to speak, you might want to talk to them about having that whale come in above them before they register.
Okay, Levi put the good thing out. Sometimes, better to be a belief below somebody than above somebody. And I'm going to let you guys talk amongst yourselves because I'm not going to give you any directions for that. But I would tell you right now, if these two were in my upline or these two were, I recruited either one of them, I would ask Jeremy, is it all right if I take your first open spot underneath you? And I'd definitely do that with John. You know why? Because I know I'm going to be able to do my part, but I want their whales, if I could capture one of their whales to fall underneath me, that's good for me. Wait.
Because it just fills up one of your spots if they're below you, but it'll fill up everything below you if they're above you.
Thank you, Wayne. Well said.
Potentially.
Okay. Yes.
And the advantage of that is that when you come in, now you've got your whole thing pretty much filled up if they're large, and you just have to give them 10 a pin, and then you've got all your levels filled up underneath you.
So if somebody's screaming at you, yeah, exactly. If somebody's screaming at you, because they fell, you personally enroll them, and they fell in your fifth tier, down here on this line. Don't let them scream at you. Just tell them you're welcome. Because now you've got 5 people above you that have filled in that organization that are trying to get 10 in their pen. The chances of your whole matrix getting filled up, let's go back to the braid and the rope, pulling it to Montana. Don't worry about where your positioning over here is. You're not going to get cut off. Yes.
Okay, so I'm a little bit confused on that point, because if all the tiers pay out equally and the 10 just go, wouldn't I want the whale below me to fill my line, but as opposed to above me?
But that if you did it that way, and you can do it that way, you're
I'm
fine.
I'm just curious to know. I don't understand what the difference is, what the benefit is.
If the whale was here, this one leg would fill up. Uh-huh. You're still getting paid good money.
Yeah.
But these would be anemic legs. What you're hearing in the audience is if this whale was above you, the chances of him filling your whole matrix goes exponentially up. But that's your choice.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, we're not. Yeah. Okay. God, I've got one more thing, and I want to get out of here.
We need to
talk
about
marketing, too.
Yeah.
So can we just clarify on the first level, the 3, you get paid $11.
Of course. I'm good. You always are ahead of me. That's where I'm headed right now.
bring them. I think some others were asking, as long as we have 10 in the pen before, what day would we be qualified for the 10 levels on the first pay day?
If you got it done by
June 6th.
No, because we'll be hanging right around there. Yeah. I would have 10 in the pen by the 1st of May. And I've got an announcement.
First of June.
Thank you. End of May. I'm dyslexic, guys. I
screw up things all the time.
Okay.
Miles Mother's Day.
All right. Whoa, listen. I'm going to take the circle, and I'm going to draw it, and I'm going to flatten it out and make it a line. Is everybody all right with that? So here's you. Will you sponsor your first three people? There is $20 of the 38 that gets paid out as commissionable volume. On your first three, $10 goes to you. So this person pays $10, this person pays $10, this pays $10. On your fourth and on, that $20 doesn't go, the $10 doesn't go to you, only $2 of it, and the rest of the $2 get out paid out too. So we pay out $1 in the TBS on everybody's first three, and we pay $2 for four then or on. What did that just do for your check, Levi?
Magnified your check.
It just exploded your check. Would you rather make $40 or $100, or would you rather make hundreds of thousands of dollars? So on your first three, we want to make sure people make more money than they spend. You've heard me say that over and over again. I'm all about three things. Make more money than you spend, find out where the world's going, and help somebody be successful. Make more money than you spend is very important. So when you sign up your first three, you make $10 a piece, plus you make your dollar from the pan. You make $11 on all your first three signups every month, forevermore. Okay? And then from there on out, you make $2 and the direct commission doesn't get paid anymore. Does everybody understand that? Okay. I have some announcements. You might want to write these ones down. Number one, the promotional code is now one word or two words. No more having to put your NUI number in.
Thank you.
You must put in rev card with two Vs. The promotional
no
number,
space.
Huh?
No space, right?
Doesn't matter. Space, no space, it doesn't matter. As long as rev with two Vs gets put in that promotional code, everybody you enroll gets the $30 waived. Until June 6th.
You mean when you're enrolling them?
Yep, when you enroll them, if they put the rev card in the promotional code, it's waived. Doesn't matter if they're a NUI member or not.
So
anybody? What? June 6th.
Rev any, card.
Rev card.
Oh, I thought you said as long as it's just REVV.
No, you must have two Vs in there.
Okay. Oh.
Rev card spelled with two V's.
Okay.
That is the promotional code.
That's it. No other numbers?
No other numbers. Rev card.
Okay.
Number two, if any of your poor people came in for $68, congratulate them. They got 2 months for $68. Does everybody understand what I just said? If you want your promotional code, it's a secret little whisper thing, and Jeremy's just going to, he probably already blasted it. So, the promotional card, rev card with two Vs. Do it in lowercase, put it all together or separate it, we don't care. Make sure that's so, okay, Jason?
I'm trying to check on right now. I believe it will be uppercase, one word.
All uppercase.
All caps.
Okay.
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 What is it again?
All caps, one word.
Okay, all one word.
Put it on the page.
We'll put it. No, we're not going to put it on the page. I don't want you talking to these people.
Anyone can use it.
Anyone can use it.
red card, all uppercase.
And that forgives the 30 bucks.
And that forgives the 30 bucks until June 6th.
Okay.
Levi.
A lot of people have tried to pay, but they couldn't get to the payment page.
We're going to clear all those out and let them start over again where it really works. Or we'll contact them one way or the other.
Well, they still took a place. They still got a number, and they've still recruited.
I know. It'll be worked out, and it'll be very, very clear.
What after June 6th?
It's $68.
Okay.
$68, and then thereafter, it's $38.
Even if they're new members.
Doesn't matter. We've given them a lot of time to get in. Okay. Do you have anything to add?
You're going to hit family.
Which family?
I don't know what you were asking. About family?
Family members?
Spouses. You were asking.
Okay, let's talk about this. We are going, when we start doing bank accounts, anybody with a Social Security can get a bank account. If you want to be a charter member, you have to be 18 or older. By law. So, can you have multiple charter members in a household? Heaven yes. Can you have a husband wife team do it? Heaven yes. Can you put an EIN number in and have another spot? Heavens no. We want one natural, real person to have a spot in our tree that has an EIN number for taxation purposes. Yes. Nothing will go to your Social Security when it comes to reporting to the IRS. It will go to your EIN number. But we need that Social Security number tied to that EIN number, just like the government does. Let me close with this. Wait. Yeah. Go ahead, John.
Two questions about the app and the there's a lot of people that when I'm signing them up, they want to know, one, the app, how will they use it? And then two, where is the list of the places where you can use that app to get those discounts?
Yeah. It will be on the app, and it'll be very intuitive, and you're going to all be able to download it on the 6th.
So if a contractor wants to know if he can go to Home Depot, and that's one of the discount places, you can look it up.
Yep, type it right in on the app and do it. You are, when we launch, you're going to have two apps. Two. One's going to be the Rev card and the Rev account, which is basically your banking app.
So no plain debit card at the first.
Just the app.
Okay.
We got too confusing, and I didn't want to have a whole. We're going to have Rev cards.
Okay.
By the way, I think last night I got my last call from a guy named Michael. And he said, why in the heck are you only charging $68 on the front end of this thing? You could get $1,500 and fund yourself. What are you thinking? That was the 16th person that told me that. Not $1,500, but why aren't you asking $500 or north? Would you like to know the answer? I want the world in this flipping thing. And if you can sell $68, a whole lot easier you can sell $500. I did that for you guys. Okay.
Richard, one more question. The Rev account, meaning the bank account, will be available when?
As soon as we get it to you. I went through the timeline. We're going to pre-launch. We're going to go to somewhere in July where we're going to start sending out text messages to you and emails to start the KYC process to get your bank account worked up. The problem is, Levi, I give you a timeline. I don't want to let you down. A lot of it has to do with integrating the archaic system of all these banks with the fresh new one. As soon as that happens, we're absolutely going to start doing the KYC. And then at that point, all the new signups are going to be right in the enrollment side. They're going to be all the way in. And then once that happens, we'll start taking orders for the cards, and all the people that are founding members will get the cards first. And we're off to the races.
So KYC, we get to find out who the bank is.
Yep, we will.
And we'll use the bank account before the Rev card.
Yes, you will. Yeah.
I'm just wondering if we have something or in the future we're going to have it. Is as we go through
three lots. Is there going to be a blog with all the updates or?
Kevin, stand up and talk to that. Quit doing work. Stay here.
Rep card. So here's the official on the rep card. We're going to make it match the logo on the card that everybody is used to seeing. So it'll be lowercase REBVCARD, no spaces. If we can program it to look at more than one card, and we will, but lowercase is one word.
And we're going to talk to Jay Mac, and we're not. That's what we want you to tell people. But we're going to have all kinds of We want people to be able to use that rev card, all one word, double V.
All lowercase.
What was the other question? Sorry.
What was the other question? Oh, well, Chris. What?
So I'm just wondering if there, through all the updates through pre-launch, is there going to be a blog or something where we can direct people?
Yeah,
we're going to have large teams, so.
So three things
is just direct people to go to the blog and get information from you guys and stuff last year.
Yes, when we relaunch.
When we start back up.
When we start back up, when someone contacts support, they will first get an email that has three, four, or five of the most common
ask questions
or error things that we're looking at, right? So they can troubleshoot on their own. The second, there will be an FAQ on the website. It will take a little bit longer, but it will be searchable. You can always search on the page, obviously, on the desktop. And three, yes, there will be a blog. There's also a Twitter handle. If you guys haven't seen that, it's comms, COMMS underscore R. And we're posting tips and tricks and answers there as well.
As well as way before we launch, there'll be live chat 24/7 in multiple languages.
Yes.
Way before we launch. Okay? Yes.
Are we getting any more promo videos?
Yes, you will. We are going to engage with Vid Army in the coming weeks, and we are going, the number one is what you just saw me draw in circles. We're going to make it fun and intuitive so you don't have to teach that to your people. And then we are going to create creative, fun videos to market with, because we don't want you to have to create anything. We don't want you to.
What was the second app?
Okay, the second app is our app. Easy name, our app. That will be your back office. You will be able to do that from the phone. Now, I'm going to hear it again. You can do it from your PC. All of you want it, but our numbers show most of you sign up on the phone. We are also going to institute not just communication with you through email, but we're going to verify your cell phone's a real life cell phone and it's you. By doing text back and forth. We're going to get you in there. Once we do the KYC, we want to know that you're you. All we're doing is upping the security on this thing.
Good. What about
yes.
PowerPoint and other materials?
Right there. Yeah. PowerPoint and other materials right there. Yes.
The headquarters of this bank is in Vegas, but we will have no. A branch here.
No. The headquarters of the banks are on the East Coast, and the original one is in Philadelphia. And the bank will ultimately end up in the state of Utah. This state has the best banking laws on the planet. We will have corporate headquarters in Utah for the banking institution.
Will there ever be a physical?
Of course there will. There will always be the branches that are open out there. And then that bank here, which by the way, will probably be housed in our network corporate offices, will be here too. Method will be there. The bank that I'm not, with no name. I almost slipped. What? Still working on getting a lease approved. We've made an offer one down by the Home Depot on 1600 North in Orem.
Oh, yeah.
We really liked that one. They came back to us and said, little tweaks. We as a management team will have our Monday morning call and say, do we want to do the tweaks? The one that we lost is still in flux. If they lose that one, we may go back to that one. So we want a professional environment, and we want something that you guys can build within. I'll tell you this, we're never going to do big meetings like this, but if you want to come in and use a conference room, we want you to be able to do that. Linda.
Can you talk about marketing and what's...
Yeah.
What we can do.
Marketing right now, when you do anything on social media, I'd really like to say I've joined a company called the RNetwork and show the video. Please don't do any more than that.
Can you show it on your personal?
You can show Facebook. The video anywhere, anyhow you want to do it. Don't have any problem with you showing the video now. Okay?
But we don't want you adding your own intros and outros on the video. Does that make sense?
Right. We don't want you to look like you're the one that built it.
There's a lot of YouTube stuff out there as well. You've got to bring that in.
Yep.
When we get a full-time compliance team, which may be in the next week or two, that will be one of the first things. Okay.
So do we report them?
Yeah, just keep sending us emails like you have been.
Okay.
Don't turn this into BYU Honor Code Office stuff. I mean, if there's something that's late, let us know. We don't want to create an environment where people are pressing the game.
Yeah. Did you hear what he just said? We don't want to be, listen, we're a long ways from regulators looking at us. If they're fragrant and they're talking about money opportunity or any of that, that's a violation we want to shut down. But if they're talking on the video and you see them talk and say, man, I just saw something that's the coolest thing in the world. It's called the RNetwork. I'm a member of it. Or I'm a charter member, I'd really like to recruit you into it, show the video and then close, don't send us that. But if they do make any type of income claims, or you know what the spirit of what we're trying to do here, if it's against that, let us know about it. If it's not, let it go. We'll clean it up in a week or so. Anybody else? Wait.
You previously said no spouses until later on.
It's later on.
So
sign them up.
Okay.
Yep.
One question I'm getting asked often is, we're paying a monthly subscription, but we don't have the card.
You're going to have on the 6th before we bill again. You will have an app which will give you the savings. It's the same app that's going to be tied into the card. We're just giving you the app first. There's the answer for you. Great question. Yes.
Why the card so far in the future?
Two things. We did some modifications on the chips to use less power, and the thumbprint reader we changed from one that was draining a lot of power, correct?
Yep.
To a new one, and they weren't prepared for our wrap-up, so they're building as fast as they possibly can. Gotcha. Straight up answer.
Do you have a card yet?
Nope. Realize this isn't prototype. This is the third generation of this particular card. We know this is going to work. In fact, the one thing I drilled down on Trent was, this going to work? This going to work? And he's like, yep, it's going to work.
Yes. Sorry, another question. As far as swipes go, how do people get paid for swipes if they don't have the card?
We're not going to do anything on swipes until we launch. So there won't be any monthly commissions paid out on swipes until the cards are all out there.
And that's January 6th.
Yep.
Six.
And so you need to expect... The first real payment is the first Friday closest to the 15th of February. Let's be, okay? Now you're going to be able to see it, what's happening.
That's on the swipes.
Yep, that's on the swipes.
Bill pay?
What?
Bill pay? Same time frame? For
mortgage? We'll probably get to the bill pay quicker than we get to the card. Yes.
So you said originally that not only mortgages but rent.
Okay.
If the landlord
should wash my mouth out with. Okay, now wait. That was a leap for me to get the mortgages. That there's no monies coming back from the mortgage company, so the bank is eating those monies. But they're not really, and I'm not going to go into it. It's my secret sauce. As we prove this up in mortgages, there is going to be a residue of income that's produced, and I'm not going to go into it. As soon as I deem, along with the bankers, that we can do this, we're going to go to rents as well. Payments on what's over your head to sleep at night, I eventually want to get to, but we're not there yet, and I'm not going to promise you that we will be there. I think, and all the people that have done the numbers, we all think that we'll be able to do anything that's paying for the roof over your head. Make sense?
Some landlords take credit cards.
Yeah, they do. And if they do, bless them. Yes.
Back to the card, upgrades on the card, they're going to happen. We need to buy a new card when they come along, like Apple.
You want to speak to this, Kev?
A little bit, yeah. So the hardware, and part of the reason this has been taking so long to get into production, is we're getting the newest, latest, and greatest hardware and bits and pieces. So just like a cell phone, we anticipate about a 24-month lifespan on the card. We'll be able to upgrade all the software and all that, but 24 months down the road, just like on your cell phone, it's probably going to have scratches and nicks and whatever anyway. That's kind of what we're anticipating at this point.
Not only that, but I'm an old fart. He has the latest and greatest. What phone are you carrying around?
Well, I need the S10. This is the S9, Galaxy S9.
I need that. I am carrying a 6 Edge, and I love it. And I'm never giving it up until I have to.
We're going to make you give it up.
Why do I say that? The upgrades on the card, the software updates are going to just happen. You're not going to know it. And what the secret sauce in the card is Trent and the software. Now, they're going to get to the point where we're going to want some robust stuff that goes in the apps and whatnot. And you'll have to replace the card, but let's not worry about that now. Go ahead. Yeah, we're going to have insurance on the cards.
No big deal. Insurance on you.
Oh, on me. Yeah, well, we've got D&O insurance and a few other stuff. I'm in pretty good shape, other than I have a little bit of diabetes, but we're good.
Roger said what they have in the future plan for the card. Functionality of the card and a range of applications is pretty exciting. Which
yeah. And I'm going to kick his butt for saying that to you. Listen, this card is going to be as much revolutionary for all of us as going from PC to cell phone. When Steve Jobs walked out with the first iPhone, he changed the world. Would everybody agree?
Yeah.
I remember the bricks.
Yeah.
Okay. This card has the potential to do something very, very special. Is it going to happen? I don't know. Depends what we do with it. When I mean what we do with it, I mean our network does with it. We get big enough, yeah, then we could do some very, very funky, cool things. And we're going to. And we're going to keep it close to our vest. And then when we do the national kite conventions, we'll roll those out and have everybody excited. If you all guys are making 20 grand or more a month, buying that $100 card is not going to be a big deal for you. Yep.
Yeah, because there's several of us in my business at my work doing this, and we're all wondering if this card picks off, we're all going to quit and our business is going to crumble.
So, sorry about that.
There's revolution already.
You sell it.
Sorry about that. Yeah.
Is there going to be to approach small business owners and how they can benefit from the savings?
Listen, thanks Linda for asking. When we get to January 6th, I want you to go to anybody that knows that they could benefit from the card. So let's say you have a brother-in-law that employs 150 people. For heaven's sakes, go in and have him give away the cards to his employees. Why? Every time the employees goes and pays something, they're going to get 10 basis points back. Hello?
So how many cards can you actually get?
We can do almost a million a week. How many personal cards?
Per person.
Okay. You can get as many as you want. You can have as many accounts as you want. That's fine. There's been people ask me about joint accounts and joint cards. We'll work through that out, all that out, and have a real solid thing before we roll it out, the cards.
Is allowing a nonprofit organization still in the scheme of the long term, at least?
Please, I want you to. I would love this to be a fundraiser for nonprofits. And there's nothing really to sell. I mean, you just show them how it works and let them start making their residual. Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
So, kind of same thing there. So, we don't have any restrictions right now going to associations that aren't nonprofits, but just the large associations.
Yeah, I would wait to do anything large that's not just people that you're building with until we have the card. Don't promise them something and kick it down the road. We're doing this with all charter members that believe in the dream and want to participate and make money like we're offering. Go into a employee leasing company or going to a large charity, it's kind of a waste of time. Wait till we get the card, then go hit those people. Make a list, check it twice, and get ready to go. Especially if I have a contact there. Guys, you've kept me longer than noon, so I'm getting mad at you. No, we're done. I want to just close with this. Thank you so much for your belief in yourself. Doing something in a startup is always a little bit scary. Thank you for having the trust and respect that you have for us as the creators. There's five of us. And then John is the president and CEO of Method, who owns the banks. This whole piece is going to be all put together and it'll be very, very clear, and you'll be proud of the brand that it's offering the dev, the rev card, and the rev account. That is a powerful, powerful thing.
You have key employee insurance.
I will have. How much do you want me to get it for? How much do you want me to get it for? If I get it in billions, it's going to cost too much, and I don't know if I can take care of all of you. I will be careful and be safe. And we've got some great minds working with me. Anything else?
Thank you.
Go have a Saturday. Thank you.